It almost seems to be a pro-PH policy to restrict the capacity of the legitimate carriers, yet the PH is not restricted because it's already illegal, but it's allowed.
The concern from Dr. Townsend that the reality of the public transport system in this country is that there is an artificially enforced capacity for taxis and maxi-taxis. Since the COVID-19 pandemic, government reduced the capacity of passengers that both taxis and maxi-taxis are allowed to carry, which up to today has not been fully restored. But Dr. Townsend said this may be an unfair advantage in favour of PH taxis, which are illegal.
Just as you have signs that say no entry to taxis, so people can run PH into Port of Spain, down to Salvatore Building, and with impunity, but it, legitimate taxi drivers cannot. And many things that are wrong in terms of how we're doing things, COVID has merely exacerbated it.
Meanwhile, research assistant Leah Wright in the same department argued that there needs to be enforcement of the law and penalties in place for breaking them.
People are doing it because they can get away with it. There's no fear or consequence to their action.
Transportation planner and engineer Catherine Agong argued, however, that regulating the PH industry is not a simple fix, since it is a much-needed service, especially in rural areas.
We need to consider that in some parts of Trinidad, there's no other alternative to travel than the PH, because people still need to get from point A to point B for their livelihoods and their life in general.
They were speaking at a virtual conference hosted by UWE, which focused on the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on transportation in Trinidad and the wider Caribbean. Sonolala, TTT News.